Pirates of the Arabian Sea. At one time, the Arabian Sea was the busiest trading route in the world. However, there was always one danger to be faced in these waters. Pirates. They lived on remote islands, paid no taxes, and had no rulers. Diwan was a pirate. His parents had been killed by tax collectors, but he had fled. Hiding on a ship, he had finally arrived, alone, scared, and hungry on a small island. From time to time, others like him had landed there, and soon he had a crew. They built their own ship and started plundering the rich merchant ships. Today, Diwan's ship lay in wait. Soon, an Indian merchant ship passed by. Diwan's ship gave a hot chase. The merchants started shooting, but to no avail. The pirates were too quick and before long had captured the merchant ship. They quickly transferred all the money and valuables to their ship and sailed off into the mist, never to be caught. The Camel Race. Ali was excited for his first camel race. His family had been participating in the race for years, and his father had won many times. Just then, he saw his closest competitor, Umar. They hated each other. Ali could not bear the thought of being defeated by him. Soon, it was time for the race to begin. A huge shouting crowd had gathered to watch. As soon as the starting shot was heard, the camels raced off. When they were halfway through, Ali noticed Umar just a little to his right. He had a knife in his hand. Umar tried to stab Ali, but Ali just spurred his camel on faster and escaped. Twisting back, Ali grabbed Umar's hand and threw a punch. Ali did not wait for more, but sped off and soon won the race. As for Umar, when the others learned of his treachery, they punished him severely. The Gypsies. A band of gypsies had set up a camp in the commons near Tidewell. The younger villagers were excited and visited the camp to buy embroidered clothes or to get their fortune told. But the older villagers were not happy. Whenever a gypsy camp came to the area, there were always many thefts. This time, the vicar's wife lost a ruby brooch, while the shopkeeper's wife couldn't find her emerald ring. Earrings, necklaces, bracelets, almost every house in the village had been robbed. When Philip, a young policeman, ordered a search in the gypsy camp, they found nothing. Then he decided to visit the gypsy camp in disguise. Dressed as a farmer, he sat to get his fortune told. The fortune teller peered into a dirty-looking glass ball and said, "I see a great future for you. I'm sure you do," Philip said. He grabbed the glass ball and flipped it over. It was full of stolen jewelry. The Trojan Horse. Greece and Troy had been fighting bitterly without a pause. The Prince of Troy had abducted Helen of Greece and refused to let her go. Both sides were equally matched, and even after months and years, neither side could win. Finally, the Greeks had an idea. They built a huge hollow wooden horse and decorated it richly. That night, they left it outside the gates of Troy. In the morning, the Trojans saw the lovely horse and wheeled it into the city. They rejoiced. "This is a gift from the Greeks," to indicate that they give up the fight. "We have won." All day, the Trojans celebrated their victory. But that night, when they were all asleep, a strange thing happened. From inside the wooden horse, the best Greek warriors emerged. They had hidden inside the whole day patiently, but now they swiftly captured and defeated the Trojans. At last, the war was over.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.